హాయ్నన్నా, సీ ఇన్ అవర్ ప్రీవియస్ వీడియో వీ హ్యావ్ లెర్న్ అబౌట్ ద మోస్ట్లెస్ కాంట్రిబ్యూషన్ టువర్డ్స్ ద పీరియాడిక్ టేబుల్ అండ్ సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద వీడియో కంటిన్యూషన్ టు ద ప్రీవియస్ వీడియో. సో యాక్చువల్లీ వీ లెర్న్ దట్ సో మెనీ ఎఫెక్ట్స్ సో మెనీ డిఫెక్ట్స్ ఇన్ ద మెండెలియ్ పీరియాడిక్ టేబుల్ వర్ ఎలిమినేటెడ్ ఇన్ ద were eliminated in the Moseley's periodic table, modern periodic table, because Mendeleev considered atomic masses as the fundamental property to classify the elements. Hence, his periodic table was defective periodic table. But Moseley periodic table, it is based on atomic number increasing order. Hence, all the element all the defects in the Mendeleev periodic table were removed in the Moseley periodic table, and we were learning. Now we will learn about the different properties, how they vary, how they change when we move from left to right in any period. Okay, so out of several properties, so this is the first property, valence. See, actually there is a gradual change in properties of elements when moving from left to right along any period. Any period you may take, so definitely there will be changes in the properties of the element when we move from one element to another element. So we will learn what are the different properties and how do they change, how do they vary from left to right along a period. So now first property we will consider, valency. See, valency is one of the property. What is valency? Valency means combining capacity of an element. See, generally valency is given with respect to hydrogen and also with respect to oxygen. See, with respect to hydrogen we can define like this. With respect to hydrogen, we say that the number of hydrogen atoms that combine with one atom of an element, the number of hydrogen atoms that combine with one atom of an element, that number is said to be valency of that element. For example, with one sodium atom of element sodium. So if you take element sodium, with one atom of element sodium, how many hydrogens are combined? So it combines only one hydrogen will combine with one sodium. Hence its valency is one. With one atom of magnesium, how many hydrogens will combine? Here one magnesium atom will combine with two hydrogen atoms. So how many hydrogen atoms will combine with one atom of magnesium? Two. Hence its valency of magnesium. So valency of magnesium is 2, valency of sodium is 1, valency of aluminium is 3, valency of silicon is 4, valency of phosphorus is 3, valency of sulfur is 2, valency of chlorine is 1. So like this, so the valency of these elements with respect to hydrogen can be defined like this. That means the number of hydrogen atoms that combine with one atom of an element. So here with one atom of silicon, how many hydrogen atoms are combined? 4. Hence the valency of silicon is said to be 4. So if you take this phosphine, phosphorus, how many hydrogen atoms are combining with one atom of phosphorus? 3 hydrogen atoms. Hence the valency of phosphorus is said to be 3. So like this, the valency with respect to hydrogen can be defined. See now, how the valency will change. For example, see actually, with respect to hydrogen, if you take the valency increases from 1 to 4. Valency increases from 1 to 4. So from 1 to 4, the valency is increased. Okay, valency increases from 1 to 4 and then decreases back to 1. So that from 4 onwards, again the valency is decreasing. So decreases back to 1 from left to right. That means as we move from left to right, as we move from left to right, what is happening? So the valency is increasing from 1 to 4 and then decreases from 4 to 1. So it happens. So the valency, how it varies? It is varying from one element to another element. It is not same to all the elements in a period. So what happens? There is a gradual change in a property. Which property here? Valency we have taken. So there is a gradual change in property of elements when moving from left to right along any period. So we have chosen third period elements. What are the third period elements? Sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine. These are the third period elements. Now if you observe the hydrides of third period elements. So this is hydride, this is also another hydride. So these are all hydrides of third period elements. And if you observe the hydrides of third period elements, hydrides means when that element combined with the hydrogen atoms, then it form the compound formed is said to be hydride. So this is the hydride of sulfur, this is the hydride of chlorine, this is the hydride of aluminium. So already we know this HCl, hydrochloric acid, it is an acid. So it is this is hydride of chlorine. So like that. So if you observe the hydrides of third period elements, these are the hydrides of third period elements. So in them, so how the valency is varying? So the valency of sodium is 1 because it is combining only with one hydrogen. So one atom of magnesium is combining two hydrogen atoms, hence its valency is 2. So like this, so the valency is increasing from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. And afterwards, after reaching 4, again the valency is decreasing. So it is not same. Is it same? No, it is not same. So it is changing from one element to another element as we move from left to right. So in this way, the properties will change. Okay, so this is an example. Valency is an example of one of the property where the properties changes from left to right. So always remember that the properties of elements, they are not same in a period. So that means all the elements which belong to a particular period do not possess same properties. They differ in their properties. For example, valency is differing. So valency with respect to hydrogen we have seen, and even valency with respect to oxygen also. Now we will learn. See, valency with respect to oxygen. With respect to oxygen, what happens? Valency increases. Valency, it is increasing continuously. With respect to oxygen, valency increases continuously from 1 to 7. From 1 to 7. As we move from left to right. That means, as we move from left to right. Okay. As we move from left to right, what is happening? So valency, it is continuously increasing. So valence is continuously increasing from left to right. With respect to oxygen, it varies like this. But with respect to hydrogen, how it varies? How the valency is changing? So valency is changing from, it is increasing from 1 to 4. And from 4 to 1, it is decreasing. But with respect to oxygen, the valency is continuously increasing from 1 to 7. So example, if you take, the same period we'll study about the oxides. Here we have studied the hydrides of third period elements. Okay, to learn about valency. Now here we'll take oxides of third period elements to learn the valency. See how with respect to oxygen, how the valency is varying. So it is increasing from 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and continuously up to 7. See, actually with respect to oxygen, what is the definition? We learn the definition, then we will easily understand how the valency values are obtained. See, valency with respect to valency So valency with respect to oxygen, with respect to oxygen, how it is obtained? So that we will see the definition. So double the number of oxygens, remember, double the number of oxygen atoms that combine with one atom of an element. Okay, double the number of oxygen atoms that combine with one atom of an element. For example, take this one, take sodium oxide. So first, how many oxygens are there? How many oxygen atoms are combining with sodium? So two oxygen, so here only one oxygen atom is combining. So simply double that number. So it becomes two. Now, so here what we have to do, with one atom of the element we have to consider how many oxygens are there. So with one atom of the element we have to see. So what is the meaning of this one? So actually, after doubling the oxygen, so we are getting some number. So that number should be distributed to these atoms. How many atoms are there? Two sodium atoms are there. So here, what is that number? Two. So every one atom of sodium will get a value of one only. So, and this value is said to be the valency of sodium. Okay, so this number should be distributed to all the atoms, because in the definition we have to consider only one atom of the element. So as there are two atoms, for two atoms it is two. So for one atom it will be one. So for two atoms together it will be two. So for single atom it will be one. So the valency of sodium will be one. So one atom of the element we have to consider. Now take this example, magnesium oxide. Okay, right. So how many oxygen atoms are there? Only one. So double the number of oxygen atoms. Okay, doubled. And so what is the number? Two. So these, how many magnesiums are there? Only one magnesium. So that one magnesium will get this number. Here there are two sodiums, so those two sodiums will get this number. But here in this case only one magnesium is there, hence this magnesium will get this number. Hence the valence of sodium is one only. Now let us learn this example. Okay, so I'm rubbing this one. See, take this example, Al2O3. So how many oxygen atoms are there? Three oxygen atoms. So double it, so six you will get. So now this six should be distributed to these three, two aluminiums. So two aluminiums will get six. So each aluminium will get how much? Three only. Each aluminium will get three only. Hence the valency of aluminium is three. So that is why valency of aluminium is taken as three. So we have to consider only one atom of that element. So we have to take here, though there are two atoms, so we have to consider only for one atom how much the valency is. So here the valency is 6 for two aluminium atoms. Hence for single aluminium atom we have to calculate, and for single atom we are getting 3. Hence the valency of aluminium is 3. If you take this one, silicon, so how many oxygens are there? Two oxygens. Double that number, 4. And there is only one silicon atom, so that silicon atom will get this 4. Hence the valence of silicon is 4. Here also, how many oxygens are there? 5 oxygens are there. So double the number. After doubling, what you will get? 10. But there are two phosphorus atoms, and 10 valency. So that means every phosphorus atom will get how much? 5. Okay, every phosphorus will get 5 only. So after doubling the number of oxygen atoms, see, double the number of oxygen atoms. So after doubling the number of oxygen atoms, okay, so that number is the valency of the remaining element. So how many atoms of the remaining element are there? 2 atoms. 2 atoms will get the valency of 10. So every phosphorus atom will get valency of 5. So what is the valency of phosphorus? Means 5 with respect to oxygen. In the same way, here oxygen. So how many oxygens are there? 3. So double it. 6. How many sulfur atoms are there? Only 1 sulfur atom. Hence the sulfur atom's valency is 6. In the same way, so here also the chlorine's valency is 7. So in this way, the valency of elements with respect to oxygen can be calculated. And after looking into the valencies of third A group elements, oxides of third A group elements. So in the oxides of third A group elements, if you observe the valencies of these third A group elements like sodium, magnesium, aluminium and so on. So sodium valency is 1 only, magnesium 2, aluminium 3. So like this. So the valencies of these third A group elements, they are varying from, they are continuously increasing from 1 to 7. So that means with respect to oxygen, the valency increases continuously from 1 to 7 as we move from left to right. Generally, if we have to consider like this. So that means, so even valency is one of the property of elements. So it varies, the valency will vary from left to right. It is not same in all the elements, it is not same. It is varying from left to right. So gradually there is a change in the valency from left to right. So that is the meaning of this statement. There is gradual change in the properties of elements when moving from left to right along any period. So which property we have chosen? So we have chosen valency. Okay, now next property we will study. Another property we will study. We'll study another property. So we'll study about the metallic nature now. Metallic nature. Metallic nature of the element along a period from left to right along a period. From left to right along a period, how the metallic nature varies. See, actually the metallic nature, what happens? It decreases. Metallic nature decreases as we move from left to right. And non-metallic nature increases from left to right. From left to right, what happened to the metallic nature? It decreases. Downward arrow means it indicates a decreasing. Upward arrow means it increases, it indicates increases. So non-metallic nature increases from left to right. See, example, if you take third period only. If you take third period elements, what are the third period elements? Sodium, magnesium, aluminum, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, okay, chlorine. So like this. See, argon also belong to third period, but argon is chemically non-reactive. Hence, the properties of these elements were studied separately. Okay, so don't include argon though it belongs to third period. So while studying the properties of elements, so we should not consider inert gases, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. So we don't consider these inert gases while studying the properties of the elements, because these inert gases, their properties are entirely different from the properties of other elements. Okay, so that is why argon is it is not included, it is excluded while studying the properties of the elements. So here third period elements, these are the third period elements. So out of these elements, actually this is a strong metal. This is a strong metal in the third period. So this is somewhat strong. This is also strong only. It is also strong metal. But this is the strongest metal. So in the third period, sodium is the strongest metal, whereas magnesium is strong metal. Okay. So what happened? The metallic nature. So metallic nature is decreasing. So this is the strongest and this is a strong one. So metallic nature is decreasing. As we move from left to right, the metallic nature is decreasing. So what happens when we come to aluminum? It is metalloid. That means there are less number of metallic properties. And even this aluminum, it is having some non-metal properties also. Got it? So that means the metallic nature is decreasing from sodium to magnesium, magnesium to aluminium, and from aluminium to silicon, still metallic nature decreases, and from silicon onwards, so here what happens, silicon onwards, the non-metallic nature increases. See, actually, from silicon to chlorine, these are all non-metals. These are all non-metals. So silicon is weakest non-metal, phosphorus is somewhat better non-metal, sulfur is still better non-metal, and chlorine is the best non-metal. So in the third period, so like this, what happens as we move from left to right, the non-metallic nature increases. So metallic nature decreases and non-metallic nature increases. So which is the weakest non-metal? Sodium is the weakest non-metal, because sodium is not at all a non-metal, it's a metal. So this is the weakest non-metal. Okay, so sodium is the strongest metal, and chlorine is the strongest non-metal. Okay, aluminium, it is having both the properties of metals as well as non-metals, hence it is called as metalloid. See, metallic nature is another property. It is another property of the elements. So how it is varying? So the metallic nature decreases from left to right. Strongest metal, less strong metal, still less strong metal. And from here onwards, non-metal starts. That means metallic nature ends up to aluminium, metallic nature ends. And so like this, that means decreasing. Metallic nature is decreasing. And from here onwards, non-metallic nature starts. So non-metallic nature, weakest non-metal, somewhat more non-metal, still more non-metal, and most non-metal. So like this, non-metallic nature, it is increasing. So non-metallic nature increases gradually along a period. So whatever the period you take, so here you have chosen third period, because in the previous case also we have taken third period elements only. So third period elements are the best period elements. Okay, of course, not only third period. So this trend or this property, it varies in a similar way in all the periods, whatever the period it may be. Okay, so the trend will be same. That means what is the trend? Metallic nature decreases along a period, non-metallic nature increases along a period. So like this, this is another property. This is another property which varies along a period from left to right. So now we learn another property. How that property varies along a period from left to right. Another property we learn. What is another property? Electropositivity. This is another property of elements. And electronegativity. Electropositivity and electronegativity. See, already we have learned that some elements will lose electrons easily, some elements will try to gain electrons easily. Some elements will try to lose electrons easily, and some elements will try to gain electrons easily. Okay, so here we learn about the elements which lose electrons. Electron losing property is said to be electropositivity. Electron positivity is nothing but electron losing property, or else the ability of an atom to lose electrons is said to be electropositivity. What is electronegativity? The ability of an atom to gain electrons or to take electrons. So electronegativity is nothing but electron taking ability of an atom. Electron losing ability of an atom is called as electropositivity. Okay, so suppose if you take any period, here also we will take third period only. So what happens, whatever the period it may be, from left to right, from left to right along a period, any period from left to right along a period, any period you may take, what happens? The electronegativity increases. I'll give you the values of electronegativity. Take any period, for example, take third period only. What are the third period elements? Sodium, magnesium, aluminum, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine. See, these two are opposite. Electropositivity is opposite to electronegativity. If electropositivity is more, electronegativity will be less. If electronegativity is more, electropositivity will be less. So like this, I'm giving the electronegative values of these elements. So just you compare. The electronegativity of sodium is 0.9, okay, and magnesium is 1.2. Here aluminium is 1.5, it is 1.8, it is 2.1. phosphorus electronegativity value is 2.1, sulfur is 2.5, and chlorine is 3.0 around. So what is happening to the electronegativity values of the elements of third period from left to right? From left to right, electronegativity is increasing. If electronegativity increases, what happened to electropositivity? Automatically decreases. That means electronegativity increases from left to right along a period, and automatically electropositivity of those elements decreases from left to right along a period. So in this way, the electronegativity or electropositivity, they vary from left to right. So these are the important values. Try to remember these values. So chlorine electronegativity value is 3.0, sodium it is 0.9, so 0.3, if you add 0.3 you'll get this, again 0.3 you'll get this, again add 0.3 you'll get this, again add 0.3 again you'll get this. Here add 0.4, here add 0.5. Okay, let it be. So in this way, electropositivity and electronegativity, these are another properties of elements. How they are varying? So electronegativity is continuously increasing, therefore electropositivity will continuously decrease. So which is the strongest electropositive element? Sodium is the strongest electropositive element, and the chlorine is strongest electronegative element, because electronegative value of chlorine is high, hence it is the strongest electronegative element of third period, and sodium is the strongest electropositive element of third period. So like this, in any period the first element will be strongest electropositive element, and the last element will be strongest electronegative element, okay, in that period. Okay, so like that. So another property we will learn another property, how it varies from left to right along a period. Oxidizing and reducing nature. ऑक्सीडाइजिंग नेचर मीन्स, ऑक्सीडाइजिंग नेचर मीन्स इट सप्लाइज एनी एलिमेंट इफ इफ सप्लाइज ऑक्सीजन टू अदर एटम देन इट इज सेड टू बी ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट. सी एक्चुअली बेस्ड ऑन ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एंड रिड्यूसिंग नेचर सो एलिमेंट्स आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू टाइप्स, ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स, ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स एंड रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट्स. फर्स्ट वी हैव टू राइट रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट्स, रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट्स एंड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स, ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स. ओके सो रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट्स विल हैव रिड्यूसिंग नेचर, ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स विल हैव ऑक्सीडाइजिंग नेचर. सो एक्चुअली व्हाट हैपेंस, सो मेटल्स, मेटल्स आर गुड रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट्स, गुड रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट्स. नॉन मेटल्स आर गुड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट, गुड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स. नॉन मेटल्स आर गुड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स. सपोज इफ यू टेक ए पीरियडिक टेबल सो हियर ओनली दिस पोर्शन ऑफ द पीरियडिक टेबल यू विल फाइंड नॉन मेटल्स. ओके हियर यू विल फाइंड मेटलॉइड्स. And here all these are what? Metals. All these are metals. There are more than 75% of the elements. So more than 75% of the elements are metals only. Very few non-metals are present in the entire periodic table. There are very few in number, 11 or 12 elements are only the non-metals, and 5, 6 or 7 are metalloids, and all other elements are metals only. So that means all the elements, the reducing property is dominating in the periodic table. If you consider the reducing property, or else reducing agents are more in the periodic table than the oxidizing agents. Okay, see what happens along a period from left to right, to the reducing nature and oxidizing nature. See, reducing nature decreases from left to right along a period, whereas oxidizing nature increases from left to right along a period. So the reducing nature decreases. For example. Sodium, take third group element, sodium, magnesium, aluminum, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine. So your strongest reducing agent, sodium is the strongest reducing agent, it is somewhat less strong, and still aluminum is somewhat still less strong reducing agent. So here what is happening to reducing agent nature decreasing, reducing nature is decreasing. And here silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine. So chlorine is the strongest oxidizing agent of third period. In third period only we are discussing. So out of all elements of third period, chlorine is the strongest oxidizing agent, where sodium is the strongest reducing agent. So the reducing nature decreases gradually from left to right along a period, whereas oxidizing nature it increases. And here and to this end, by the time it reaches to this end, so it will be strongest oxidizing agent. That means oxidizing nature increases from left to right. So this is the weak oxidizing agent and this is the strongest oxidizing agent. So this is the strongest reducing agent, this is the weakest reducing agent. So like this we can discuss about the oxidizing and reducing natures of the elements along a periodic table. Now we learn another property. Another property we learn. What is that one? Nature of oxides. Nature of oxides. How the nature of oxides will vary? How the nature of oxides will vary along a period? How the nature of oxides will vary along the period? See, actually, metal oxides, this is the most important thing. Metal oxides are basic in nature. Basic in nature, remember. So, metal oxides are basic in nature, and non-metal oxides. Non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. They are acidic in nature. What is the nature of metal oxide? Basic. What is the nature of non-metal oxide? Acidic in nature. So the basic nature. So what happens along a period? Remember that. Along a period what happens? Metallic nature, already we have seen, metallic nature decreases. So as metallic nature decreases, therefore, okay, nature of oxides, what happens? Nature of oxides. So from metallic to non-metallic. So in a period, the property changes from metallic nature to non-metallic nature. The property changes from metallic nature to non-metallic nature along a period. The properties changes from metallic nature to non-metallic nature. That means metallic nature decreases. Therefore, nature of oxides, what happens? Nature of oxides, how the nature of oxides varies? So they change from basic oxide to acidic oxides. Example we will learn. This one with one example. Third group, let us take the same group, third period elements we will take. So oxides, so we are discussing about oxides. So take third period oxides, oxide of sodium, oxide of magnesium, oxide of aluminium, oxide of silicon, oxide of phosphorus, oxide of sulfur, oxide of chlorine. So what happened? Basic two acidic oxides. See, actually, so these are the basic oxides. These are the strong metals, and strong metals are strong basic oxides. They are basic oxides. And this one is amphoteric oxide. What is the meaning of amphoteric oxide? Amphoteric oxide means, so this particular oxide, it shows both basic nature as well as acidic nature. That means it will react with acids as well as with bases also. Okay, but these two, they react with acids only, because these are basic oxides, hence they can react only with acids. But this one, it is amphoteric oxide, hence it may react with acid, or else it may react with bases also. And these oxides are acidic oxides. They are acidic oxides. Because from here onwards, non-metallic nature increases. So non-metal oxides, they are acidic in nature. So that means they are acidic oxide. These are acidic oxides. This is the strongest acidic oxide, and this is the strongest basic oxide. That means when dissolved in water, so this will form strongest base, and this will form strongest acid, when dissolved in water. So like this. So these are the oxides, how they vary, third period oxide, how they are varying in their nature. So here the nature of oxide can be discussed in two ways: acidic oxides and basic oxides. Acidic oxides and basic oxides. Okay, so actually, so the basic nature of oxides, so as we move from left to right, so the basic nature of oxides decreases and acidic nature of oxides increases. So this is the strongest base basic oxide, less strongest basic oxide, and here the basic nature, of course, it is having acidic nature also along with the basic nature, and here from here onwards, so acidic nature will start. So acidic nature, strong acidic nature, still stronger acidic nature, and most strongest acidic nature. So this oxide is strongest acidic oxide in this period. So in the third period, so the chlorine oxide of chlorine is the strongest acidic oxide. So what is happening to the basic nature? So here we can discuss like this: the basic nature of oxides. If you discuss, so basic nature of oxides. Basic nature of oxides, it decreases. Whereas acidic nature of oxides increases. See, if you see, so this will exhibit very, very, very weak acidic nature, but strong basic nature it exhibits. So this one will exhibit very strong acidic nature. It exhibits very weak basic nature. Okay, so like this, the basic nature, what happens, it decreases, and finally decreases along a period, and acidic nature of the oxides increases along a period. So in this way, the nature of different properties we have learned. So there are so many other properties also, but these are the important properties. So how they vary along a period from left to right. Okay, right. So some more properties, if time permits, we will learn some more properties in the coming classes, in the future classes. Okay, in the future videos we will learn some more points about the properties. Okay, bye now. So in the next video we will learn some more things. Okay, like typical elements, ridge elements, diagonal relationship between the elements, say, and all those things we will learn in the next video. Right.